You know, one of the things that I love to do now is fish deep offshore structure and kind of fish with my eyes underwater, and that's using your electronics. You can take a finesse rig like this, drop shot, and get out on some of these deeper points and things like that, and really be efficient at targeting individual fish. Until a few years ago, our electronics just didn't really do the job to allow you to do that. So, I'll just kind of troll and zigzag back and forth off some of these flatter points like this, looking for the actual fish, an individual bass, bait fish, whatever, and you can just drop right down, drop this drop shot rig right down to them to catch them. There's been several of them in this area, so I'm just kind of zigzagging back and forth looking for them, and when I do see it, I'll drop it right down to it. Oh, here's one. And I just marked one right here at 20 feet. Try to drop right down to that zone and just hold it there. Even though I can see them, you can't still tell what they are, and this lake, there's a lot of gar and stuff in this area, so you mark everything, whether it's a bass, a gar, drum, carp. But if you can kind of see those fish relating to the bottom, that one was up off the bottom a ways, chances are that's some kind of non-target species fish. If you can mark them where you can actually see them relating to a little ledge or a drop or sometimes a stump or a brush pile, things like that, you can be very efficient at catching them this way. I mean, love to fish for smallmouth that way. We do it a lot on the Great Lakes where we just actually look for them out on those big flats in Lake Erie, Lake St. Clair, things like that. Just drop a drop shot right down to them. Great thing about this drop shot rig is it's a finesse presentation, but when you've got that weight down below there, every time you shake it, it makes that worm just really stand out on the line, that thing is just looking like a real bait fish down there. You wiggle it a little bit because of that tension, and it really moves that worm. So even a lethargic fish has a hard time passing that up. So much of what we do as pro anglers now is you try to be as efficient as you can with your techniques, and this is one of those things where you might spend a little while with your bait out of the water, but when you do see something, you got a really high percentage of catching that fish. Another thing is I always have one of these drop shots rigged up anytime I'm fishing offshore structure. If I'm throwing a crankbait or whatever, running ledges like that, I'll mark fish occasionally, and then I'll just pick that drop shot up and drop on them, even if I'm using other lures or techniques. It's a great technique. Now, we just don't fish blind anymore. Our electronics are so good that we want to, have ourselves not only on a good piece of structure, but a lot of times I won't even fish a spot until I see the fish on the graph. I may go through it and side image it or down image it first and then drop down on them. And if I see them like that, you got a good chance of catching them. It's a great technique. If you haven't tried to fish with your eyes underwater like this, it's something that you have to do because it's just so efficient and effective to catch these fish that are just scattered on these bigger flats. If you're casting around, you're hardly ever gonna catch one. This way, I've got my lure right in front of his face when I finally do come across him.